Some final things that we'll talk about here. Just go back into this menu. Gonna grab, let's say, all the faces here. I'm gonna go to Unitize. What Unitize does is it basically turns everything into a general square. So every single UV, every single face on this object has now been turned into this tiny little square. Again, how can we make use of this? Well, I'm gonna go ahead, do like I did before. Select some loops, shift select, and I will move and sew those. Because I did this unitize, I've got a nice squared out shape here, and all these guys have given me an even kind of rotation. I've selected one too many rows on this one. But I could have chosen not to stitch those guys together. And if I wanted something very similar to the original UV layout that was there, I could do something exactly like that, in fact. Something like that. Double click that. So it gives me all these guys, and then shift select this to invert the selection, and I'll go ahead and do a move and sew, and you'll see I get this big grid shape. So this can be done for all sorts of things as well, things that you know that you want to have perfectly straight lines for. You can use Unitize on those specific faces, grab your any kind of set here of edge loops, and then only stitch together the ones that you want together. In addition to all of this, we also have your layout command, and the layout command has a bunch of options. So we can pre-scale. This option allows you to either actually scale each individual shell based on what we have on the object or how it perceives it in the world, or to not do any scaling of any kind in order to arrange this, because perhaps you wanted to devote more texture space to a face or any specific object. Any of this here would go ahead and try and align it so that everything had even texture space. We have per object, we can say if we want to have overlapping, so if we don't care that each shell is overlapping each other because each shell will have maybe its own shader assigned to it, you could go ahead and do that. Otherwise, it will try and prevent them from overlapping. If anything's reversed, it'll automatically flip it so the text and so on don't appear backwards. It should work within the region, or we can tell it just a long UV, or not to respect anything at all, just kind of lay them out and then we'll decide later. To do any additional scaling, to scale them all uniformly or stretch to the region to fit within that one-to-one space. So if it goes ahead and stacks the entire set but discovers there's a lot of unused space, what it will do is it'll scale it either to the right or left or up or down in order to fill that space. Then the cell stacking will use the shape. So if you had two triangles, they would stack close to each other along their edge so that it would basically create a quad shape, versus bounding box, in which case one would be stacked above the other or to the left of it, as if it was a square. Then we have the rotation, telling it to rotate freely in order to fit the best way possible, or only by 90 degree increments, or not to scale or not to rotate at all if your alignment of that particular piece makes more sense to you. Say you're going to texture it in Photoshop. And then we have shell spacing, and basically what this does, let's just get down into this space here, turn this stuff off. What we have here is our one-to-one region, and right now it's going to tell it that it's a 512k map that we're going to do there. And what this means that we have 512 pixels going across versus down, And this spacing is essentially within the range of the size of one pixel in that relative space, so that when it puts the shells together, it makes sure that there's at least a pixel's worth of distance between them, so that you don't get any bleeding in terms of the colors onto your objects. And they have various different sets here, but you can do your own custom size however you may want to work with that, because it stops at 2048, and if you're doing a 4K or something higher than that, you may want to get them even closer, and you can go ahead and do that. So that's the basics of your UV sets. There are certainly other options in here. You can go ahead and try and warp the image. Some of these things already exist in here. There are several of these options. And we've got copy and paste. Copying one UV set to another UV set. If they have the same point number, that may work for you. These are just all your ones from the UV set editor. They're just existing in here. These are the options that are existing up here. We've had a brief look at some of this stuff already. We've got our pixel snap options, which is right up there. And the ability to go ahead and update and create PSD networks. This would require using a PSD to texture this. And this only updates for things like the existing shaders from Maya, the Lamberts in Blends, etc. It will work for V-Ray stuff. I've tried it with Mental Ray. It doesn't seem to update with several of the Mental Ray shaders. So it's very specific use. But it is interesting. It basically will just automatically update whatever you've done inside of Photoshop, if that's what you've been using to texture. So if you're using something like Mari or Mudbox or ZBrush or something like that, it won't do anything for you. This is basically just when working with Photoshop. And your selection options, control right click options, are right in here. And then just some more visibility options here. So that's pretty much it for UVs. The last thing that I will show you here is something that you'll want to know, which is the UV snapshot. Once you have it in that one-to-one region, remember that a lot of things inside of Maya works based off that one-to-one region, so baking as well as things like what I'm about to use right now. So I'm just going to go ahead and grab these UVs. I'm going to go ahead and tell it to lay them out. Press A. And this is not necessarily the most optimum, but that's what it's given me. Something like that. And I go do a snapshot. What it does is it will bring up this little window, which will allow me to go ahead and pick the format that I want to save to. So if I do something like PNG, for example, what it will do is it'll draw all the edges, but it'll leave the background transparent, which is nice if you want to paint underneath it. And it will save to wherever you tell it to, and will use the texture size that you've assigned here. And you can tell it to maintain aspect ratio. So if I were to go 4096, for example, it will automatically do that. Whereas if I don't want to keep the aspect ratio, I can turn it off and say 512, and it will do rectangular shapes. So you basically just select all your UVs, you go to UV snapshot, make your settings, choose where you want it to go, and all will be good. So that is, in a nutshell, your UV sets. So there it is.